Hi guys, my name is Kirsty and welcome back to Upside Down Books. Today we are going to be picking my September TBR and this is Chris, the one and only boyfriend that you are probably familiar with if you've been following for a while, and he is going to be picking my November TBR. Did I say September? It's the November TBR.
Yeah, you said...
No, I said September TBR, didn't I?
You'll go to say September and then you'll just voice over. November.
November TBR.
But like with no emotion.
Mm. So how are we going to do this? How do you want to pick my TBR?
Books. I need books.
Well, we are sitting in my collection of books. I don't have a theme that I want for my November TBR. I was originally thinking I would do mythology for November, but I am going to hand you the reins completely and everything you say goes. So I'm really hoping that you don't pick anything too scary.
Oh, like the biggest books you have.
To be fair, I am reading War and Peace at the moment, so I feel like... You can't one-up me on that one, so everything else is fair game. So, we both read fantasy. What are you reading at the moment? Let's start with that.
I'm reading God's Grave by Jay Kristoff. And, what's that non-fiction book that I'm reading?
You're reading a non-fiction book?
Yeah.
I thought you finished your non-fiction book.
By Stephen Fry.
Oh, you're reading Mythos.
That's right, Mythos. I've only just started
Does Greek mythology count as non-fiction though? Because I think that's its own genre. If you're reading mythology, you're reading mythology.
Okay, well, we'll call it mythology then.
So we have a couple of books that we both own and are thinking that the TBR is going to look something along the lines of us doing at least one buddy read, if not a few. I think we have like two or three books.
Over three.
Three books that both of us have, so I'm expecting to see a few of them on there. We haven't discussed what Chris is going to be picking for me, so this is just going to go off whatever vibe you're feeling, whatever you think I'm falling behind on, or whatever punishments you're basically going to lay out for me to get on top of the many different facets of my reading on which I am not on top of. And I don't know which way you're going to go with it, but I'm a little bit nervous. Should we start with the buddy reads?
Yeah, let's start with the buddy reads.
Do you have any idea how you want to do
this? I don't know where these books are. Like, I don't know what books you want to read, or if there's like...
Oh, it's not really about what I want to read. Like, I'm sort of imagining this is just going to be all the things that you're like, why haven't you read this yet?
I don't actually know your list. So, the thing is though that, unless... Are there books that I've been saying recently, it's like, why the hell haven't you read this yet?
Yeah, I mean, I feel like that's...
Why have you not read In the Night Circus?
It's not In the Night Circus. It's The Night Circus. I feel like you mixed that with In the Night Garden. You know, the kids' TV show.
Oh, yeah. Why have you not read The Night Circus?
That's not in this room, I don't think. I think that's actually in my...
Because I just saw...
The Starless Sea.
The Starless Sea.
Well, at least I've read that one. So are we starting with The Night Circus then?
Yeah, so Night Circus, book number one. How many books? 6? 12?
Yes. Oh, yeah. We should probably start with rules of how many. So typically, I haven't done a TBR for a while because I have been taking a break from it to just catch up and read and go wild and do whatever. So I think it's been about 4 or 5 months since I've done an actual TBR jar, but I usually pick 6 books, so I think the aim will be for you to pick 6 books for me to try and get to, and I don't see why I wouldn't get to them, because I've been reading close to 10 over the last month or so.
10?
So, yes.
Okay, so we picked 12 books.
No, we want this to be a feasible goal, but we'll see where we are at the end of 6 books, because if you pick any small ones, then maybe we could pick another big one.
Maybe we need to have like a max page count for the month, and then you pick books that fit into that page.
That would
count.
Be a very reasonable way of doing it, but who's listening to reason? Do you want me to get The Night Circus?
Yeah. So many books.
All right, so the first one's going to be The Night Circus by Erin Morgenstern. Chris has been on about this one for a very long time as to why I haven't read it.
The first time I met you, I had mentioned this book.
Yeah, yes, it has been a relationship long thing. I have read, under your... At your behest, I have read The Starless Sea, and that was very good. And
it
I've
took
heard...
me a while to get you to read it, though.
No, it didn't. Mm-hmm. It was like 2 months.
Nah, it wasn't 2 months.
I've heard lots and lots of good things about The Night Circus, not just from yourself, but from everyone else. So I am going in with incredibly high expectations. I'm a little bit nervous that my expectations could be too high and that I might be let down with this one. So what did you like about this one?
I mean, I read it probably 3 years ago now. Or 4 years ago now. So my memory on the story is a bit...
I was going to say, do you actually remember what happens?
I remember the primary pieces of the book.
Okay. All I know is that there's a circus.
Mm-hmm.
That's it.
It's called The Night Circus.
Does it happen at nighttime, or are they all wearing black?
I'm not going to spoil anything.
Oh my gosh. Is it the same style of, like, same genre as The Starless Sea?
Maybe in the same vein, but not. They're different. They're quite different.
So it's not like magical realism?
There is some magic in there, but it's just read it.
Thank you for your eloquent words of wisdom. All right, that's book number one, The Night Circus. Are we going to read? We'll talk about order when we have all of the books.
Mm.
Right, so we're going to move on to the second pick. So we've got one out of six.
Babel. Where's the book?
Babel. Okay, so the only edition of Babel I have is actually right here, and I have the Fairy Loot edition with the really lovely sprayed edges.
I thought you had the
standard copy as well. No, not for this one. For some of the other ones we have, yes. So I would be reading it without the jacket on.
Okay, you're going to read this copy.
Yes. I'm a firm believer, though this may make some of your toes curl, in using, like, not collecting things just for the sake of collecting it. Mm. I don't want to just have the Fairy Loot editions and never read them. I'm not buying them just for the purpose of reselling them. This is for my enjoyment, and so I can see all the artwork inside. So,
yeah, that's right.
Babel is by R.F. Kuang, and this is the same author as the person who wrote The Poppy Wars. I don't own The Poppy Wars, so you can't make me read that for this month.
I do.
I know you do, but we can't do that.
What if I just bought you the first book?
Well, too late, because we're filming this now.
So we're going to be doing The Poppy Wars as well. No, we currently don't have the book.
No, we're doing Babel.
But I will get a copy of the book, and that will be available for this month.
Okay, look, if I get through the other six books, then I will consider reading The Poppy War.
Consider? No. All right, if we're going to do this, you will read The Poppy War.
Not all three books. No, we'll put a pen in that idea. But you have Babel as well.
I do.
And this has been very popular and well reviewed at the moment. So this one is, I want to say it's a reimagining revolving around the Tower of Babel, but I think it's using the Tower of Babel fable as a setting and a point of origin for where the story is going to go next. Mm. Because this is set in 1836 in Oxford, and I think it's set in a, are they magical translators? Because it's the prestigious Royal Institute of Translation.
Mm. I read a little bit of the blurb, but I kind of stopped myself because I just wanted to
dive in blind. There's something about an empire and magic and all that stuff. It's quite a big read.
Mm.
Take you out of it. But yeah, I'm happy with that. That's a big book. What was the first? I've already forgotten. The Night Circus.
Night Circus.
So we're working with The Night Circus and The Tower of Babel so far. I'm pretty happy with this.
We'll do order later.
It's like a fantasy-heavy month.
Two fantasy books.
Well, you know, I'm hoping for the trend to continue.
Okay. Well, let's get more then.
Were there any other... okay, so from a logistical point of view, Chris, how much do you read a month?
Not very much. Maybe two books a month?
Not bad.
Or three books a month? Yeah.
Relatively speaking, quite a lot of reading for a year, but less than I read, so we can only pick
probably one
or two buddy reads. So is this, do you want to do another one? Yeah, Chris got upset because when we read Gallant together, I sped ahead of him.
I was halfway through the book and you finished it. Actually, no, I was a third of the way through the book and you finished it.
Well,
and then I sat there the whole day being like, I've got to finish the book.
It was a small book. I was keen to get to the end. Okay, so are we just going to do Babel together and we'll save the others for another time? Or do you want to pick two buddy reads? This is a pretty big book.
We'll just do Babel.
Okay.
Because the other one is a Tower of Gold or something?
It's like a Taste of Gold and...
Silver? No. Have you got it here?
I think it's literally right here. Yeah, a Taste of Gold and Iron. That's
Gold and Iron, there we go.
We'll maybe do that another month. On to the third book.
What is it, Behemoth?
The second book to Leviathan?
Yeah.
I think so, because I think the last one is called Goliath. Shall I get the
book? And it's a steampunk series,
it's a steampunk,
right?
Historical fiction, like, retelling of World War I.
Mm. Yeah.
I will get the book. Please hold. This is Behemoth, yes, by Scott Westerfield. So it's, I almost want to say it's middle grade. It's one of the coolest series, I think. I didn't actually rate book one spectacularly highly. Because it wasn't quite what I expected, but I still really enjoyed it because it's got quite large font and it's got illustrations in it. So it kind of reads as a middle grade, but I have committed to collecting the entire series in hardback. And it has the prettiest end covers. They all have really cool end covers in them. And papers even. I think I rated the first one potentially 3 stars, but maybe 4.
I thought you loved it. You told me a description of it when you were talking about it.
I did love it, but it wasn't, it felt wrong to rate it like 5 stars, because...
Why not 4?
I can't remember what I rated it. Shall I check?
Yeah.
All right. I went in expecting something that was like an adult historical fiction, and mm-hmm. it was much younger than that. So the tone of the book sort of threw me, and I think just kind of left me a little bit... What did I rate it? 4 stars. No, that's the average rating.
Oh, that's the average rating.
No, I still rated it 4 stars. Yeah, yeah. 4 stars, but it didn't... I had expected it to become like an all-time favourite. Steampunk and historical fiction are some of my favourite genres, and I don't know of anyone else who's gone for such a big, like an actual historical fiction that they've steampunkified. Because steampunk by default is obviously set in the past.
It's like a future, like 1900s technology. It's like if we...
Well, it's not future. You mean like what they imagined?
Yeah, it's like... Yeah. Like that kind of era, but the technology is taken further. It can do more, and machines are made out of that sort of thing.
Mm-hmm. No, I'm keen with that. I think that's a good idea, because then I can continue the series. And I just got Goliath sort of recently, so
that's from the UWA thing, right?
I think it might have been. Yes, it was. Yes.
Yeah, because you got this book with it.
When I did like my 30, 40, 100 million book haul. Yeah. Okay, to the pile. Book 4, have we got any ideas? So we've got 3 books now, and it's slightly overwhelming, the number. We now know how many books are in this room as well, and we know that it's over 800 books in this room, a large percentage of which are unread. So for me, when I'm looking at what I have to read, there are a bunch of non-fiction climate change books.
There we go. What about the recent David Attenborough book you got?
Oh yeah, that's Living Planet. That's this one. Inspiration immediately. That's this one. It's not a new David Attenborough, but it is a new cover of one of his older ones. It was one I didn't realise I hadn't read.
It's got really lovely pictures in it.
Yeah. I remember when I bought this, we were together in a bookstore, and I was debating about whether I should buy like the smaller edition of it, but the bigger edition came... I think this one came with the coloured pictures, like the photographs.
Yeah, there was some... thing that we thought, no, it's best to get the smaller version.
No, the taller version.
I mean, the taller version.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't remember why. Was it the pictures?
I think it was the pictures. It's just nicer. I usually buy all of my, like, climate change books in this vein. I buy them in hardback just because I think they look nicer and I, like, actually want to collect them. But there wasn't a hardback where we were, but I still wanted to get... Oh, there's so many pictures in this. There are literally... You can see maybe the gradation of... where all the picture breaks are throughout the book. There are many.
Is he going around the whole planet? Or is what's
Living Planet, the second book in David Attenborough's groundbreaking Life trilogy. Oh, have I read the other ones? Anyway. Explores the intricacies of how life lives on Earth. With his characteristic blend of curiosity and enthusiasm, he explores the rich variety of life on Earth, focusing on the interdependency of living organisms that allow them to exist, thrive, and replicate. I don't know which ones I've read. I mean, I know it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, but...
No, I want to... Oh my god. Look at the number of books this man has written. That's a lot.
Life on Planet series.
So I've read...
Hang on. Living Planet. Where's that one?
This is Living Planet.
Oh, so it's the second in that trilogy.
Yeah, it's the second. There's Life on... I don't think I've read the other ones. I've only read his memoirs and not... I actually don't think I've read... Now that I think about it, I don't think I've read that many books by David Attenborough that are just like the informative ones.
I honestly think you've just read one.
No, I've read two. I've read two of his... I've read A Life on Our Planet, which was a memoir, and I've read not Adventures of a Young Naturalist, but that's also on my TBR. Other memoir. Yeah, I've not read that.
No?
Well, we're going to have to go book shopping.
Not super keen on the cover, but...
I think that's why they rejacketed.
Oh, that's true.
Love me a David Attenborough on my TBR. Makes me better happy. Would you like me to walk you through more genres? Or have you got an idea?
No.
So there's some crime. I probably wouldn't do more than one non-fiction.
No.
But, you know, if you feel particularly evil, then you could pick another one if you wanted to. There's obviously a lot more fantasy, Like, there's so much fantasy to get through. There's stuff that's been gifted to me for presents and birthdays that I haven't got to, that I'm not going to be reading in December. I feel like there's, like, big hit list items that neither of us are remembering.
Yeah, no, there's definitely some that you haven't read at all.
You could always look, is it books that you've read?
Or
is it books you want me to read so that you know whether you want to read them? I like that I'm, like, the test guinea pig.
Yeah, no, because, I mean, you know how long it takes me to read a book, so I'm like, if I'm going to devote that amount of time to it, I want to know.
I've got to cop the fall.
I know.
Are there any series you think I should be continuing? There's also that challenge.
You should read The Bone Witch.
That feels particularly mean, given that you didn't like it.
The Bone Witch. I love the cover, though. I absolutely adore the covers.
Why didn't you like this?
I don't know if it was audiobook related or the story or my expectations really didn't, I feel didn't really, were met in the book at all. Because, I mean, the audiobook, the narrator was very breathy for, I think her name is Tia from memory, the main character in the book. Yeah, it's spelled like T, but it's pronounced Tia.
Tia.
It was very breathy. It was like,
I can't stand breathy narrators, and I can't stand narrators that have like the same cadence. They're like da 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 da.
But the main character as well was very that classic kind of does everything wrong kind of character. And I don't know, it felt like it followed just like a cookie cutter kind of thing. And then the
can't wait to read it.
And the magic that's in the story or in the book is so amazing, but it feels like they just kind of tease you with it the whole way through the book.
Mm.
Love the cover, love the idea of the story. Possibly was put off by the narrator in the audiobook version.
So essentially you want me to read it to see if it was actually rubbish or if it's
good. I mean,
good.
I tried the second book of the series as well.
But also
I was immediately
on audio.
Put off.
Yeah. Well, to be fair, I've heard a lot of people love this series. Like, they think that this is the bee's knees. So I have very low expectations.
And I mean, your friend as well was on Instagram.
Sean. Lonely Reader, yes.
Yeah,
he's
he loves
a big fan
it as well.
Of this, so. It might be good.
Yeah, you might love it.
It might
and
be terrible.
I think this is
it's about witches. It feels like a little bit sacrilegious to be reading witches in November. I feel like I should be gearing up for Christmas. And what doesn't say Christmas more than David Attenborough and witches, right?
And steampunk.
And steampunk historical fiction.
And a circus.
Okay, well, we can do The Bone Witch. Right, we're five books down. So we're five books down now, which means we've got The Last Melon. I'm surprised that you haven't...
You want me to pick Rune of Glass?
I was just going to say, I'm really surprised you weren't like, Queen of Shadows, you have to read it now. But I also just finished reading Air of Fire. I wouldn't mind a little bit of breathing space.
Yeah. I want to put Terry Pratchett on there.
I don't have... I mean, it's up to you. I don't have the first Terry Pratchett book. I have Colour of Magic, which I read...
No, if I was going to give you a Terry Pratchett book, it would be Thief of Time.
That's not the one I have.
That's my copy.
It's not on my TBR. Can't do it.
But it's...
No deal.
But it's a book that's within...
No deal. He didn't say Terry Pratchett. What? What? Oh, no, I'm worried.
My mom bought you the book recently.
Oh.
That one.
Oh. Let me see if we're on the same wave.
Six Crows and Cranes.
Yeah.
The second book.
I was going to pull it out.
I think it's in your room.
Lynn? No, it's not.
Am I sitting in front of it?
Well, you should be. Oh, no, here it is. I found it.
Come quick.
Here it is.
So what's this title?
The Dragon's Promise.
Sequel to Six Crimson Cranes, I think.
Yes. This was so good. It was a really interesting read, the first book, because I went into it, like, knowing that it was very popular, but... When I actually started reading it, I was a little bit concerned that it wasn't going to be, like, particularly wowsome. But I loved it. Look at that map.
Look at that map.
That's a good map.
Awesome. I haven't read it.
No.
I don't know anything about it. I just know you loved the first book.
Yes. And it had dragons in it. Because this is... I'm unsure because I have still not looked up. It looks like Japanese mythology, but it could be Korean. I really enjoyed this because you've got, like, this sort of... rebellious princess who doesn't want to be married and like runs away on her wedding day sort of thing. And then just everything's downhill from there. And there's lots of interesting characters going on. There's like shapeshifters, there's dragons. Like the dragon can come into human form sort of thing. And she's got a mission to do and she gets banished. And like the most interesting thing, and this isn't spoilers, I found it really funny trying to picture it because she's cursed with a wooden bowl over her head that I think covers down to her eyes. So the whole time...
She can't see.
She can see. It's like transparent to her, but everyone else just sees this girl with a bowl on her head. And they're like, why has she got a bowl on her head? Hmm. And she's like, can't remove. And I just thought that was the most hilarious thing to picture because it was so ludicrous. But it was really good and it ended on a cliffhanger. And I want to know, I can't remember what the cliffhanger is now.
You got to go and read the last page.
Oh yes, I was going to say reread it. Yes, that's an excellent pick. Right, so that is the TBR for September. I keep saying September. It's the TBR for November, and
We're a couple of months out of September.
I feel like that's a pretty good pick. I feel like you've done a pretty good job. Like, I'm really looking forward to reading Babel and The Dragon's Promise, probably, and David Attenborough. They'd be my three top picks out of what you've picked for me. I mean, I'm looking forward to The Night Circus as well, because I know that you really enjoyed The Night Circus.
Yeah, I enjoyed it. Yeah.
It should be a good month of reading.
So what order are we going to do this in then?
Oh yeah, order.
So I'm thinking Babel should be maybe like week two or three to start.
Mm-hmm.
Give me time to finish God's Grave. Maybe, I reckon, Bone Witch first. I'll put them in order.
Bone Witch first. All right. So
Bone Witch. Then I think we're going to go The Night Circus.
Feel like you're super smug about the fact that you've got me to read The Night Circus.
How long is that going to take you? A week to do both?
Look, in a perfect world, it would take me a couple of days, but who knows?
We're going to do David Attenborough.
Yes. I have to wait so long to read The Dragon's Promise.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then we can do Babel.
And then
we'll do... Yep. So you're going to read Dragon Promise before Babel?
Yep, that's the plan. I think we can do that. Well, I mean, we'll see what happens anyway. And we'll roll with the punches. And hopefully you can keep up with me in Babel this time.
Or maybe I'll start sooner and then you can...
Yes, you could get a little head start and we'll see how that goes.
I'll get a 100-page head start and then you'll overtake me in the first day.
It's possible. Anyway, that brings me to the end of the video. So I hope you enjoyed this video with Chris picking my TBR for me. Let me know if you've got any of these books on your TBR or if you've read them. I'd love to hear your thoughts. But other than that, I will see you in my next video. Goodbye. All glory militar.